Sure. Because of my line of work, I have to have my real estate license as a requirement.
I've never brokered a residential deal before, but I can look at everything online like anybody else can.
We'll really just be able to work at our own pace, finding the place on our own. I'm pretty confident that I can do it.
Jocelyn has decided to broker the deal, which is good and bad. I just didn't want her to have that stress, but I am excited for her to make the commission.
If we buy a house that is 200,000, the commission's going to be 2.7%, which is almost $6,000, which is awesome. I would love to have $6,000.
The must-haves for our first place are 3 bedrooms, 2 bathrooms, storage space, and big backyard.
Backyard is really important to us because I have my little Toby and he loves to be outside. We want to stay kind of close to downtown where we work, closer to like a hip Portland area.
Sure. One thing I want to make sure is that we really stay within our budget. I don't want to overextend ourselves. What do you think is a fair place to even start?
You know, I think we could afford something that is around the, $250,000 price range. I know that's probably not what you're thinking.
If we get into a situation where we're barely scraping by month to month, that's not fun. If we look at house rates of right around 200K or so, I really think that that's going to be right in our price range.
We can start out definitely in the 200 range, and maybe it turns into 225.
I think we can do that.
I'm acting as the realtor today, so it's just Jeff and I. I've seen these houses online before, so I have a pretty good feeling of what the layout is.
It's a cute house.
Yeah, it's really cute. This one is a 2-bedroom, 1-bath, 1,070 square feet, and it's listed at 215.
Well, let's check it out. Oh, interesting. See, it just seems a little bit tight in here or
Yeah.
something.
Seems pretty small.
Yeah, I do like the big window there. That's kind of a cool feature to it.
Let's take a look at the kitchen.
Okay.
Looks like it's straight off of the living room right here. It has new cabinets. It's pretty big.
Yeah, for sure.
Let's go see the master bedroom.
All right, let's go.
Looks like it's through the living room. Wow, this is very small.
Well, what about the closet space here?
Where are you gonna put your stuff?
Yeah.
There's a sliding glass door off the bedroom here.
Nice deck, I guess, but
Yeah, this yard is really tiny too.
not a lot of privacy.
Well, you want to go take a look at the bathroom?
Yeah.
This is pretty much it. It's really, really tiny.
Is this what we're getting for 215 now? I
I
mean,
guess
this
so.
is really frustrating if this is kind of what we're dealing with.
The second bedroom is down the hall, and this is pretty much it.
So it's about the same size probably as the other one.
Another sliding glass door off of this
Yeah,
bed.
I guess
Yeah.
for sure that's the only way to get to the backyard is through a bedroom, which is
Yeah.
kind of iffy.
That's kind of scary. Anybody could just walk right up into the door.
So this definitely isn't the house for us. The price point's at 215, and this just isn't the house that we want for that price.
Let's go. Let's see what else is
Go.
out there.
This one looks interesting.
Cute.
Yeah, it is.
So this one is listed at 197. It's
Okay.
a 3-bedroom, 2-bath,
Okay.
and I think it's about 1,300 square feet.
Oh, yeah. Huh.
That's a really spacious room in here.
Yeah, look at this room in here.
Yeah.
Man.
I like the hardwoods. It looks like they're really new.
Yeah, the hardwood looks good.
And it's open to the dining room too, so you can sit at the table and watch TV.
Let's go check out the kitchen. For as much space as the rest of the house has so far, this is kind of tiny in here, isn't it?
Yeah.
We have some countertop issues here, but that's redoable.
The floor totally needs to be redone.
We can make this work, I really think.
Looks like the bathroom is out of the kitchen to the right.
That's kind of an interesting setup.
Yeah, the situation was the seller was in a wheelchair. I think we'd want to have it turned back into just a half bath.
Yeah, sure. So, what's upstairs?
There are 3 bedrooms upstairs and a
All
bathroom.
right, let's go check it out.
So the master bedroom is across the hall to the left.
Wow.
Yeah, this is really pretty big.
Yeah, I mean, we could fit the bed plus a couple of dressers in here.
So the bathroom is kind of to the right. It's pretty big. And you could definitely just take out this vanity and put like Jack and Jill sinks. Let's go see the first bedroom. It's across the hall from the bathroom.
Okay.
This could be like a front office room.
Like an office room, or we can just use it for storage as well.
Well, the third bedroom is to the left of the master.
We have the double closet again, which is, we could fit between all these closets up here, we could easily fit all of our clothes.
Yeah, that's nice. Well, let's go take a look at the yard. I like the back porch.
We probably have to fence it off on this side for the dog, but other than that, this yard's great. It's huge. There's lots of potential here. This house, is it the right price? It's the right size? It has the right yard? It has so many things going for it. It has a few things to do, like the kitchen and the downstairs bathroom.
Mm-hmm.
But other than that, there's not much wrong with this place at all. I'm really excited right now.
I know, me too.
Let's go get the offer rolling on this thing. I don't want to miss this one. Let's go do it.
Okay.
With their future on the line, can Jocelyn handle the pressure of brokering the deal?
What should the offer be then?
I'm not quite sure.
And will their do-it-yourself approach cost them their first place?
We found that there are some big things wrong with it.
I just feel like I might be a little in over my head.